super bummed by that.
Undertale Megalovania Hard by Loluigi. Trademark.
Hard art was trending on Twitter? What?
It's got a 1.01% clear rate.
Smaggle Daggle, in what context was it trending? Was it like because of that kid that missed his PK?
You are dead!
It's gonna take me a while.
Imagine dying.
Yeah.
Because three back and failed the goal. Yeah.
These comments are really boofing me here.
Okay, well, the one dude really messed it up. Like, the goalie drove the wrong way, man. Like, I'm not saying anyone deserves to be called that.
What a fucking...
He messed it up.
You're, like, trying to justify it a little bit, but still...
No, I'm not saying he deserves... I think it's still wrong.
I need to turn comments off.
Wasn't that kind of like the story of the entire tournament, that PKs were just terrible the entire time?
Probably. Isn't that always the case, though? Like, PKs are such a horrible system of deciding matches.
That wasn't even close.
I don't think they deserve that, but... No. Like, it's unacceptable. I just understand how someone could be so frustrated that they would resort to using that. That's all I'm saying. I don't think that was a save. I'm just...
Oh, do I get a checkpoint? Oh, no checkpoint. Dang it. Oh, it's not... I thought I was dead a while ago, to be real.
What a fucking...
Get some nice banter, some fun shit, nanigans going on.
What?
Politics is better than sports fans.
They call them dumps. Big, massive dumps.
Oh, man. You must really hate sports. Posting a meme in your DMs, do not show it. It's really saucy. Okay. I didn't plan on showing it, but okay.
But can you show it now, though?
I guess I'll show it now, since you said not to.
I want to see a softie.
Wouldn't that be so much sillier?
I'll go very out of my way to show it on stream.
As every streamer does, show their Discord.
Right, that's always a good... Yeah, showing Discord DMs on stream.
Why are we watching Avi's Marvel Runs videos?
Because it's quality content.
This is not...
What else will we watch?
There are no checkpoints in the Sans fight. Well,
isn't that what got Schlatt in trouble?
What did Schlatt do?
I have no idea. I like Schlatt, I think.
I don't know.
Wait, am I allowed to say that?
Are you? I don't know. I don't really know who he is.
Scott...
That's my favorite. People are mad at him because, he's...
Did he say the hard R2? I can't believe it. I'm done watching him.
Did he say it because the goalies missed PKs?
He's playing Minecraft, and then the goalies, they missed the thing, and he said the hard R. I can't believe it, Schlatt.
The 12-year-olds in the Minecraft community don't like him because he's too edgy sometimes.
Yeah, he said the hard R. Of course he's edgy.
Is he a Minecraft streamer?
Sort of. So he became famous off of Minecraft. He made this video called A Tribute to Minecraft, which got like a million views, where it was just basically him saying, like, hey, I grew up on this game, and a lot of people did. It's a great game, whatever. And then, Call Me Carson started his SMP live, server.
Yeah.
And Schlatt was one of the first people on that. And he got famous from that as well. Now,
yeah, take notes, Quentin. Maybe if you played Minecraft.
Well, looks like we're gonna just sell out and play Minecraft from now on, ladies and gents.
Quentin, for a while there, he was making a lot of videos on Wii games.
I never understood.
Ooh, that's like me.
Standing a team outside of video games.
But this isn't a Wii game, so I guess no one's gonna watch. Sorry, everyone, please leave.
Pause. So you're saying you understand like. Watching esports but not real sports. Here are the hot take of the century.
Standing a team outside of video games. Why would it be different between esports and regular sports? There's still people that you have no real connection
because
to.
Because these esports people are doing stuff that does not push the limits of the human body.
So no, they say the hard R a lot.
Oh, fucking righteous fucking
That's true.
They
records for that.
have you seen some of the reactions?
Have you seen PewDiePie?
But can you do this?
What a fucking
They are literally pushing the limits of how fast you can do certain things.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah, but that's not impressive because they're not catching a balls. They're not catching balls.
I'm not saying it's not impressive. I'm saying like you can't say that esports is impressive while saying that real sports aren't.
Yeah, they're kind of they're the same real concept there. And come on, dude.
I don't know. There are certain games where it takes a lot more practice to master than it does for a normal sport.
You don't master normal sports.
Okay, become top of the...
And probably not. Probably at the very worst, like, it's a comparable amount of time.
I like
you mean like StarCraft or something?
Well, StarCraft is purely mechanical, right? But if you take one that's...
I would say it's purely mechanical. Like, even if you're the best mechanical player, if you play a slightly worse mechanical player who, like, has a better strategy for your given setup, right? Like...
Okay, but what I mean is, like, if you take one that's highly strategic and highly mechanical, it takes a lot more time investment than, say soccer, for example. Because in soccer, perhaps, let's say, you... are starting from nothing and you have to get your body to a physical shape in which you are at the peak and then start mastering soccer, perhaps.
I got trolled.
Uh-huh.
But some of these games, like, let's say Dota, for example, there are so many different mechanics and different ways to play the game that it is impossible to master it. But you can, in soccer, feasibly push the limits of the human body, as you're saying, to the quote-unquote peak, where at
but
the
that's
point
that's reaches, the thing though is like with
returns
with sports like that where it's like a direct competition, which is like I call sports offense defense things, right? So like golf's not a sport, it's a competition.
Now watch this drive.
So with sports, it's never about just your skills in a vacuum, but it's always about your skills compared to whoever you're playing against. And so it's a similar amount of variation of like all the different things that you have to be aware of and tracking with to try to actually beat the person. Like I've argued for both camps before. I don't know where I stand fully anymore, but it's just like I don't agree with this notion that like video games can be so much harder to master, because I don't think we've ever, like, Wayne Gretzky is probably the closest we've seen to like an actual sport master.
I think they're just like, they're not necessarily the same thing. They're just mastering things, not necessarily mastering the same type of things, like mastering video games and mastering sports. So I think it's fair to just, you know, there's the same cheering aspect for both of them. So in the end, they're, you know, very similar things.
Maybe the point I'm trying to make is that they're both impressive and incredibly hard to get good at. And it's not fair to say that one isn't hard to master. They are
both they're hard to get good at.
But my only point is that certain video games, just because due to the nature of the complex, like, rule sets and other things that you can put into a video game, has a much higher skill cap, I'll say, than perhaps a physical sport.
That's a weird thing. That's like an apples to oranges comparison, in my opinion.
For example, you compete...
like, you mean the gap between floor and ceiling, kind of thing, or like just their skilled players are more skilled than other people's skilled players? Because I think that comparing like the high skill players to other things, it doesn't make sense as a comparison to make. But maybe you can make the argument like that the gap between floor and ceiling is bigger.
I wouldn't necessarily gap between floor and ceiling. My only point that I'm arguing against is saying that my initial point that I'm trying to argue against, I don't even know what I'm trying to argue at this point.
I don't either. I don't know what I'm arguing.
It's just that sports are pushing the limits of what humans can do. And I argue that games do the same, if not even more.
Interesting. I think they're not physically demanding as well as mentally demanding, and so that's just, it takes away a lot for me, personally.
Yeah, most people aren't going to see someone sitting down at a computer. I'm not saying it's just someone sitting down at a computer. They're just going to see that and not assume they're doing as much. That's what most people, I think, would see in it.
I mean, you see esports professionals, and it's like, they might be in good shape, but that's because they chose to be, not because they need to be. How much did the viewer count drop in this?
Not much. It's been near it's been like 17 to 19, and we started with like, you know, 22 when we first started the podcast, so.
I think all these gamer nerds really love Scott arguing here, and they're like, the sports guy knows nothing. It's true, I don't. Scott's winning.
Winning at what? It's not really a real argument on either side.
We're not really not arguing.
We're just
it's
a discussion.
It's really hard.
It's a discussion,
like,
not
yeah,
an
no,
argument.
This is
yeah.
Very hard either way. No, Scott's the real black guy, Smaggledaggle.
Yeah, he's the black guy that's
just the voice.
In the bottom right hand.
Funny voice.
Yeah.
Honestly, if it was just Scott streaming, probably we'd have like more viewers.
There'd be a lot more, like, we get more than Troy's viewers.
Troy, please raid me.
You've like ruined all chances of the raid happening, man.
Troy also went to high school with Scott, by the way. Same graduating class. They both sat at the same table. They never let me sit with them.
Well, yeah, because that was the cool kids table.
Well, I thought I was kind of cool.
Quentin wasn't cool enough.
No,
I thought I was a little cool.
You never beat anyone in Mario Kart tournaments.
On Thursdays,
girls,
I was kind of
so.
Cool. I lost all
the
girls.
Chess club day?
That's when I did the Carol Con on Thursdays. I never won with it, but I still did it.
I still did it versus the chat. I won with it.
I blundered my queen and lost all my... I lost my king in, like, the third move. I still did the Karo Khan. The shirt matches my pick.
I'm gonna read Virox's argument points about the standing a video game team outside of a normal team.
Wow. You can talk and become friends to a cracked person in Mario Kart Wii, but you're never gonna associate with someone in real sports.
I mean, I guess so, but like...
I disagree that video games are more easy to access. Sports, a lot of sports are a lot cheaper, especially like soccer. Soccer ball costs way less than...
You're watching the new
video?
Nice.
I was gonna watch it, and then it was like, oh, it's premiering in 1 hour, and I was like,
you should watch it now. It's up now. Whatever. I don't need your viewership. You're smelling, you like sports instead of video games, so you suck.
You're right. I'm so stupid. How could I think?
Yeah.
How could I think that sports are more accessible than video games?
You must be foolish, okay?
Don't you know that to play video games, all you need is a couple $100 for a console and then like $60 more for a game? Whereas in sports, you need like a $10 ball and an open field, which you can never find anywhere. Gosh, I'm so stupid.
Shut up. You're salty.
How do you claim accessibility? Like maybe for disabled people? Like what?
I think what he's saying is like it's easier to get in touch with them, maybe. Like if you're just like watching like the Quintus Minimus stream and then you join my Discord and DM me afterwards, like, hey, now you're talking.
You'll be severely disappointed.
You'll be disappointed, but at least you accessed something.
Oh, he actually is black.
Oh, what's up?